That's a massive.
I've just arrived.
He went for a hole there, boys, that was not there. Not for the spectators.
This is frightening stuff. Alan McNish is still in the car. At first glance, guys, I don't think the gap was there. Let's take a look down through the Dunlop curves. He goes inside Bernard. That's for the lead of the race.
It wasn't there. I mean, we're talking about it. It's really difficult to see out of that car, and it just...
Peter Aronson tried to get out of the way, but the leader is blocked. And there's contact. Was Postiglione's car, I fear, that's up the escape road, and straight away, I think the officials are going to have a look at that. And there was contact between Maron and Blomstedt, and a red flag. The race is stopped. The race is stopped because it's taken barriers down, and there is obviously... straight away.
Services around the country. An awful incident involving an Aussie race car, and Brendan Tucker, check this out, for a roll that gains momentum. Bang, can you count that? Actually, these blokes up here can't count to that sort of number.
That
was a lot. This is extraordinary. Now, the good news is that Brendan got out of the car all okay. I just kind of couldn't figure out which way north was, but otherwise fine. That's amazing and testament to the strength of the cars. So it's all going to play out this weekend, folks. We are going to have a huge weekend.
You can see Mike moving inside the car. He's going on the inside of Ryan Hunter-Reay. This reminds me almost of Dan Weldon's crash here in turn 3 and 4 quite a few years ago. And the car is up into the fence, which is almost reminiscent of Kenny Brack's accident at Texas quite a few years ago, guys. Very, very lucky.
You know, he was incredibly lucky that he did not go head into that fence. That is a horrible impact.
Wow. All right, let's go on board from Elio Castroneves' point of view.
You can see Mike was trying for some reason to go on the inside.
Wow, he almost collected Anna Beatrice. Now from Ryan Hunter-Reay's car.
So you can see that he got hit on the inside and up over the top, and you can see Ryan Hunter-Reay moving his hands, and he looks up in front of him and he goes, my gosh, I can't believe that.
Oh, wow.
Rain falling, you can see the rain. Very narrow. No, that was not going to happen.
No way.
Oh, they're still at it. They are still at it.
Now these two boys are going to calm it down.
Boys, bro. Oh, my God.
That's not on. That's lunacy, boys.
That's just crazy stuff, two guys.
It's one thing to have a go and not
not get it right, but to carry on like that is lunacy, and they should be slapped over the wrist. Have a look again. Stanaway makes the move. The block's there. There's no room.
No, but he moved weight. That was a bad move there by Pye, I'm afraid. But he shouldn't have moved over that far.
Then there was more contact on the exit. This was the run. He's blocking the line. Stanaway's having a go. Open wheeler. It launches off.
I can't believe that thing wasn't damaged then. I mean, that was an amazing recovery by Stanaway to get through there.
Well, he made it around the corner, and then it kept going. And Nick Perkat, we said just sit back and wait and watch. Look at all this. That's one hit.
Perkat used his brain here big time. And
he needs to absolutely hook it up now. This is so close.
In he goes. Solberg into the joker lap, into the right-hander, into the left-hander. Ekstrom swings around the cross. Solberg's run wide. It's going to be a race to the line. Who's going to take it? Too close to call. It's Solberg takes it. 1/100 of a second. Unbelievable. Solberg takes it. 1/100 of a second.
Here we go, look, this is it. So you can see Solberg just searching for traction, trying to get it to bite up. Excellent, look how close that is.
Unbelievable. Wow. If he'd mounted the transponder extra just a centimetre further forward, he might have got it done. That is incredible. 0.005 of a second, we think it is. Oh, incredible.
About to happen in front of him, so he slips along.